Want to speak real Dutch from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at DutchPod101.com.
Today we're going to focus on 10 questions you should be able to ask and answer in Dutch. The first one. Hoe heet u? Hoe heet u? What's your name? An answer to this could be Ik heet Jacob. Ik heet Jacob. My name is Jacob. So this is just your basic introduction, but an important thing to remember is that the Dutch word u is very formal. So if you want to ask a coworker or a classmate or someone who is the same age as you what their name is, you should probably say je instead of u. So it would be hoe heet je? Next question. Hoe gaat het? Hoe gaat het? How are you? And an answer might be met mij gaat het goed. Met mij gaat het goed. I am doing well. Now, this is a pretty long sentence that you don't necessarily need to, you know, say in full. If someone asks, hoe gaat het? You can just shorten it and say, goed. Waar kom je vandaan? Waar kom je vandaan? Where are you from? Sample answer, ik kom uit Amsterdam. Ik kom uit Amsterdam. I am from Amsterdam. Now, if you're just asking this question flat out, then people might consider that to be a little direct. So a more gentle way of asking this is just assuming that someone is from somewhere and then letting them correct you. So you could ask, kom je uit Amsterdam? Which means, are you from Amsterdam? And then someone else could say, no, actually, I'm from Haarlem. Hoe oud ben je? Hoe oud ben je? How old are you? Possible answer, ik ben 20 jaar. Ik ben 20 jaar. I am 20 years old. So if you're answering this question, you may actually leave out jaar. You can just say, ik ben 20. And leave it at that. That's more common. Waar werk je? Waar werk je? Where do you work? Ik werk in Rotterdam. Ik werk in Rotterdam. I work in Rotterdam. Though this sample answer is a city, you're more likely to get an answer with something like, I work in marketing, or I work at Coolblue, or whatever. So when you're asking someone where they work, it's assumed that you're talking about the job, not the actual location. Here's an opportunity to learn some numbers. Wat is je telefoonnummer? Wat is je telefoonnummer? What is your phone number? Answer. Mijn telefoonnummer is 012-345. 6678. Mijn telefoonnummer is 012-345-6678. My phone number is 012-345-6678. So now you also have an idea of all the numbers from 0 to 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hou je van Nederlands eten? Hou je van Nederlands eten? Do you like Dutch food? A likely answer to this is nee, ik hou niet van Nederlands eten. Nee, ik hou niet van Nederlands eten. No, I don't like Dutch food. So some typical Dutch dishes are hutspot, which is mashed potatoes with mashed carrots, and beschuit met muisjes, which is like a crispy biscuit with small pink or blue and white little balls on it, and they're made of sugar and aniseed. And that's traditionally eaten at the birth of a child. Well, to celebrate the birth of a child. Heb je broers of zussen? Heb je broers of zussen? Do you have any brothers or sisters? And an answer to this may be, ja, ik heb een broer. Ja, ik heb een broer. Yes, I have one brother. So there's no real Dutch equivalent to the word siblings, so you'll always have to ask if they have brothers or sisters. It can be a little bit of a pain, but there's just no alternative, so sorry. Ben je wel eens in Nederland geweest? Ben je wel eens in Nederland geweest? Have you ever been to the Netherlands? A likely answer. Nee, ik ben er nog niet geweest. Nee. Ik ben er nog niet geweest. No, I haven't been there yet. Waar heb je Nederlands geleerd? Waar heb je Nederlands geleerd. Where did you learn Dutch? It's so incredible. Sample answer would be, ik heb het op school geleerd. Ik heb het op school geleerd. I have learned it at school. I don't actually know if there is any country except for the Netherlands where they teach Dutch. We're not very popular in that sense.
Want to speak real Dutch from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at DutchPod101.com.
Hello and welcome to 10 Dutch phrases you always want to hear. Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. You look great. Let's start with, je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. You look great today. Always nice to hear, right? Don't use it too often, you don't want it to lose its meaning. Ik mis je. I miss you. This next one is rather sad. Ik mis je. Ik mis je. I miss you. As you can hear, the Dutch and English version of this are very similar, so it's easy to remember. You usually say this when you're on the phone with someone, in other words, when they're not actually there with you. Or you say it about someone else. You could say, for example, ik mis mama. I miss mom. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. This is a nice one if you want to tell someone they did well. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. You can also shorten it to goed gedaan or goed zo, meaning good job. It's a little more casual that way. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There's a bonus at the end of the month. So nice to hear. Sadly, it doesn't happen as often as we'd like. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So imagine you've gone to dinner at a friend's place and the food was great. You could say, je kunt erg goed koken. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So if the food wasn't really good, but you still want to be polite, but you also don't really want that person to ever touch a pan or a stove again, you can say, dankjewel voor het koken. Thank you for cooking. This is still very nice, but you don't have to actually say that dinner was amazing. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Isn't that nice? When someone tells you to just sit down and relax for a while. Maybe try using it today and say it to someone. You're sure to make some friends that way. En jij wint. And you win. So this is what you say at the end of a game. En jij wint. En jij wint. And you win. You can also say it to end an argument if you feel that maybe the other person was right after all. You can say, all right then, you win. Vooruit dan maar, jij wint. It will get you some points to admit you were wrong. Je had gelijk. You were right. This next one is also great to admit you were wrong. Je had gelijk. Je had gelijk. You were right. Feel free to say this to me anytime. I don't mind. I really don't. Ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. I've brought you something special. Now, imagine you've taken a long trip and you have brought a special gift home with you for your sister, who is Dutch. You can give it to her and you can say, ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. Ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. I've brought you something special. Now, please don't say this if it's just a t-shirt with the Eiffel Tower on it. Really save it for when you really picked out something special for your sister. Het budget is onbeperkt. The budget is unlimited. This one is really nice if you're planning a party and you want to hire a fire breather, but you're not sure if that's too expensive. And you ask that to someone, is that too expensive to hire a fire breather? And they say, het budget is onbeperkt. Het budget is onbeperkt. The budget is unlimited. This means, go ahead with the fire breather and make sure everyone has their own personalized cocktail. This party is going to be great. 10 phrases you never want to hear. Ben je de laatste tijd iets aangekomen? Ben je de laatste tijd iets aangekomen? Have you gained weight recently? So, not really sure why you would want to say this to someone because it's usually not received well. But if you ever feel the need to insult someone, you know, have a nice one up your sleeve. Next one is slightly less bad. Je hebt een grijze haar. Je hebt een grijze haar. You have a grey hair. This is still not exactly nice, but it isn't terrible either. I guess it depends on how you say it. This next one is as annoying as it is satisfying. Ik zei het toch. Ik zei het toch. I told you so. It's satisfying to the one who's saying it, of course. Pro tip, only say it to yourself, quietly in your head, or whisper it under your breath so people can't hear you. Now, this is really one you don't want to have to say or hear. Je bent ontslagen. Je bent ontslagen. You're fired. So if you ever have to hear this, you will at least know it wasn't your perfect Dutch that did you in. Ah, this one's terrible. Het ligt niet aan jou, maar aan mij. Het ligt niet aan jou, maar aan mij. It's not you, it's me. Nasty one, isn't it? Because it invariably kind of is you. But that's okay, nobody's perfect. Just have a good cry and move on. Bedankt voor je cv. Helaas is de functie al ingevuld. Bedankt voor je cv. Helaas is de functie al ingevuld. And that means, thank you for your resume, however the position has been filled. So in Dutch, CV stands for curriculum vitae. We don't really have another word for it, like the English have resume. So this is an important one to remember. Next one. Ik maak het uit. Ik maak het uit. I'm breaking up with you. I'm so sorry to have to teach you these unpleasant things, but they are unfortunately a reality for most of us. So at least now you will be prepared. Let's move on quickly. So here's one that is bound to make you nervous. We moeten praten. We moeten praten. We need to talk. Not anyone's favorite sentence in the world, probably. So be careful how you use it. Moving on to the next sentence. Sorry, ik ben het vergeten. Sorry, ik ben het vergeten. Sorry, I forgot. So this is something I have unfortunately said a lot. I try really hard, guys. Don't be mad. Ugh, this last one isn't messing around at all. U bent ernstig ziek. U bent ernstig ziek. You have a serious disease. Well, if that didn't lift your spirits, then I don't know what will. Sorry to have to leave you on such a serious note, but next lesson will be happier, I promise.